Have you ever experienced that your robot collides with its surroundings when restarting it after a program stop? In this video, I'll show you how you can create a before start sequence that checks the robot's current position. And if the robot is in risk of collision, moves it safely to its starting position. Start by inserting a before start sequence in the program. When you start the program, this sequence is executed once before the main program starts. In this sequence, I will start by checking the robot's position. To do this, I use a variable which I'll name current pose. Next, I'll assign the coordinate values of the robot's current position to this variable. This is done by calling the function getActualTCPPose. This function returns a pose variable containing six values. The first three values are the TCP's position on the X, Y, and Z axes, relative to the base feature and written in meters. The last three values are axis angle positions in radian. Next, I'll look at the application to find out which position values I need to check. The risk of collision occurs when the robot stops inside the cardboard box. This means I have to check the robot's position on the blue Z axis. If it's less than 350 millimeters, there's a risk of collision. Now I have to isolate the Z value from the current pose variable. Each value in the variable has a position starting from 0. This means that the Z value is stored in position 2. I'll create a new variable to store the Z value from the current pose variable. Then I'll assign it with the value of the current pose variable, but only the Z value, which was stored in position 2. This is done by writing 2 in square brackets after the variable name. The next step is to check if the Z value is less than 350 millimeters, which means the robot is inside the cardboard box. Remember, distance is written in meters. If the Z value is less than 350 millimeters, I'll use a script command to modify the Z value. I assign position 2 to the pose variable, which is the Z value with the value 0.35, which means that the Z position is moved to the top of the cardboard box. So now I have modified the current pose variable to reflect a position where the robot is not in risk of collision. Now I just have to move the robot to this position. To do this, I use a move L with a variable waypoint, and I select the current pose variable as the position to move to. So what this sequence does is start by reading the TCP's current position. Then it isolates the Z value of the current position and checks if it is less than 0.35 meters. If it is less than 0.35 meters, it modifies the Z value of the current pose variable to 0.35 meters. And finally, it moves the robot to the modified position by using a variable waypoint. When the first waypoint in a program is variable, the robot will start moving when play is pressed, and no auto move is needed. You need to take this into account in your risk assessment. For example, you can insert a pop-up before the first waypoint that informs the operator that the robot will move automatically when the program continues. Universal Robots Academy also offers free, interactive online training where you can learn all the essential concepts and commands needed for programming a UR robot. And we have more than 50 authorized training centers worldwide where you can sign up for hands-on training by certified instructors. Available at academy.universalrobots.com.